بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم. ڈیئر اسٹوڈنٹ، السلام علیکم. امید ہے کہ آپ سب خیریت سے ہوں گے. آج جو ہمارا ٹاپک ہے وہ ہے کمپلیٹ ایکولیبرم سے ریلیٹڈ ہم بات کرنے جا رہے ہیں. اس سے پہلے آپ کو ایکولیبرم کے بارے میں بتایا جا چکا ہے، فرسٹ کنڈیشن اور سیکنڈ کنڈیشن آف ایکولیبرم کے بارے میں آپ کو ان ڈیٹیل بتایا جا چکا ہے اس سے پہلے والے لیکچر میں. اب جو ہم بات کرنے جا رہے ہیں وہ پہلے ریویو ہم بات لے لیتے ہیں کہ فرسٹ کنڈیشن آف ایکولیبرم کیا ہوتی ہے. فرسٹ کنڈیشن آف ایکولیبرم کے بارے میں آپ کو بتایا جا چکا ہے، فرسٹ کنڈیشن آف ایکولیبرم، وین سم آف آل فورسز ایکٹنگ آن اے باڈی از زیرو دین باڈی سیٹسفائڈ فار دا فرسٹ کنڈیشن آف ایکولیبرم. اف فورسز آر کو پلینر دین وی ریزالو فورسز ان ٹو ریکٹینگولر کمپوننٹ، دا سم آف آل فورسز ایکٹنگ الانگ ایکس ایکسز از زیرو، اینڈ دا سم آف آل فورسز ایکٹنگ الانگ وائی ایکسز مسٹ بی ایکول ٹو زیرو. دس از دا فرسٹ کنڈیشن آف ایکولیبرم. نو we discussed about the second condition of equilibrium. When the sum of all torque acting on a body is zero, then body satisfies the second condition of equilibrium. The second condition of equilibrium can also write as the sum of all torque, the clockwise torque is equal to sum of clockwise torque must be equal to sum of anti-clockwise torque. Then body also satisfies the second condition of equilibrium. Now we come to the complete equilibrium. What is mean by complete equilibrium? When both equilibrium, both condition of equilibrium satisfied, then body is said to be in complete equilibrium. Now we discuss about the definition. When the first condition satisfied, this means no net force acting on a body, so it will represent translatory equilibrium. No net force, when no net force act upon a body, so it will represent translatory equilibrium, then the body in translatory equilibrium. The equilibrium name is translatory equilibrium. It means it is about the linear equilibrium. So net force is equal to zero, net acceleration is also zero. According to Newton's second law, F is equal to ma. This is the in vector form. Net force is zero, ma, mass cannot be equal to zero, a is equal to 0. So net force is equal to 0. Then no acceleration, it means the body is in translatory equilibrium. When the second condition satisfied, this means no net torque, no net torque acting on a body, so it will represent rotational equilibrium. Net torque is equal to 0, then alpha angular acceleration is equal to 0. When we discuss chapter number 5, then in chapter number 5 we discuss in detail about angular acceleration, that is represented by alpha. For complete equilibrium, both the first and second condition must be satisfied. This is a very important. When object is in complete equilibrium, then first condition mean translatory equilibrium and rotational equilibrium must be satisfied, then the object is said to be in complete equilibrium. For example, in case of couple, the body satisfied the first condition of equilibrium, but body do not satisfy the second condition of equilibrium, it means body is not in complete equilibrium, because the body has tendency to rotate. No linear motion produced in case of couple, but angular motion, the rotation, angular motion or the rotation is produced in the case of couple. So we can say in case of couple, no, body is complete equilibrium, body is not in complete equilibrium in case of couple. Now here we discuss about a diagram. Suppose a meter rod, two forces acting at the end from the axis of rotation, this force is also at distance r and this force is also at distance r. This is the action of rotation. This is the action of rotation. This is the force. This is also force. And this is the moment arm. Moment arm defined as the perpendicular distance between the axis of rotation and the line of action of force. These are two forces that are acting in upward direction, F plus F, 2F, and this is 2F in downward direction. Upward, not a body is moving upward direction, not a body is moving in downward direction. So body has no tendency to stop moving, then the body has no tendency tendency to move, then the body has no linear motion. And here is a clockwise torque and here is the anticlockwise torque. Sum of clockwise torque and equal to sum of anticlockwise torque. So body has no tendency to rotate. The body has no tendency to linear motion and no tendency to rotate. So we discuss the body is in static equilibrium. First condition and second condition, we explain net force is equal to 0 because F plus F 2F acting in upward direction and 2F in downward direction, no net force. Net force is equal to 0, body at rest and no tendency to start moving. Second condition satisfied because no torque, anticlockwise torque and clockwise torque are equal in magnitude. So, they cancel each other effect. Net torque is equal to 0, body at rest and no tendency to rotate. So, we can say that in this case, body is in complete equilibrium. Here, I discuss another figure. This is the motor rod. This is the axis of rotation. This is the axis of rotation. This is the force and this is also force. Both forces are equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. Body has no tendency to accelerate but it has tendency to rotate. This force and this force. This force is in upward direction, this force is in downward direction. No linear motion but rotational motion is produced in this case. First condition satisfied, net force is 0 because upward force and downward force both are equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. So, they cancel each other effect, but these forces have different line of action of forces. So, these forces produce turning effect. So, net force is equal to 0, body at rest and no tendency to start moving, linear motion, no linear motion is produced. But angular motion is produced. Second condition not satisfied. First condition is satisfied because no linear motion is produced. Okay, no net force acting on a body, so it will represent translatory equilibrium. Net force is 0, acceleration is 0, so body is in translatory equilibrium. Now we discuss second condition satisfied. Second condition not satisfied because for second condition, net torque must be equal to 0. Here, torque is not equal to 0. Body has tendency in clockwise. This force is also produced clockwise torque and this force is also produced clockwise torque. Both forces produce torque. So, body has tendency to rotate. Dear student, I hope you learn easily about the complete equilibrium. Now, I again repeat about the complete equilibrium. When the first condition satisfied, no net force and no net acceleration, that is the translatory equilibrium. When net torque is equal to 0 and angular acceleration is 0, then body is rotational equilibrium. When both, for complete equilibrium, both first and second condition must be satisfied. So, dear student, उम्मीद है कि आपको ये समझ आया होगा. अल्लाह हाफिज़.